Hi, this is Ms. Barnacle again. This is Section 32A, Least Common Multiple. When we talk about least common multiple, it's similar to saying least common denominator. In this section, we're not going to have fractions, so we use the word multiple instead of denominator. But when we get to that, we'll deal with it. Now, the thing you need to know is, what is a multiple? Multiples are numbers that are the products when you multiply factors together. Like 2 times 3 is 6. 6 is a multiple of 2, or a multiple of 3. And then you want the least common multiple. And what we're going to do is find either pairs of numbers or groups of numbers, and we're going to try to find the smallest number that all of them divide into. So I have a few examples. This is an example of finding the least common multiple of 6 and 8. And you can list the multiples. And when you make a list of the multiples, we're going to do that in a minute, where you just do 6 times 1, 6 times 2, 6 times 3, such as that. And you find the smallest number that they both divide into, which that one was 24. We're going to work a couple on the board. And let me go up there. All right, I have 8 and 12. So what we want to do is we want to list the multiples of 8. So we say 8 times 1 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. 8 times 3 is 24. 8 times 4 is 32. And you would keep listing if you needed to. All right, then we list the multiples of 12. And we say 12 times 1 is 12. 12 times 2 is 24. And I really don't need to go anymore, because what I've done is I have just found the smallest number that both 8 and 12 will divide into evenly. So that is my least common multiple between 8 and 12. Now, sometimes you're going to have a list of numbers that's more than 2. So you just have to do it for all 3. If there were 4, you would do it for all 4. So when you have a problem like this, 2 is a very small number, and it may take us a long time to get all the multiples of 2 listed. So if I start with my bigger numbers first, sometimes I can find the answer faster. So if I start with the 10, the multiples of 10 are 10 times 1 is 10, 10 times 2 is 20, 10 times 3 is 30, 10 times 4 is 40, and so on and so on. Then we list the multiples of 15. 15 times 1 is 15, 15 times 2 is 30, 15 times 3 is 45, etc., etc., etc. So when I think about 2, what I want to do is I want to find the smallest number first that 10 and 15 have in common. And the smallest number that the two of them have in common is a 30. Now, what I do is I'm going to look at 2 and I'm going to ask myself, does 2 also divide into 30? Because if it does, then that's my least common multiple, which it does divide in there, because 30 is an even number. So 30 is the least common multiple between these three numbers. Now, sometimes you can do it a different way to find the least common multiple. Same concept, only we're going to list factors. We're going to go backwards. Instead of listing least common multiples, we're going to list factors, and we're going to find it that way. When we do that, if I use the same 8 and 12, let's use 12 and 20. 12 and 20. When I list the prime factorization for 12, those are the factor trees. We've done those. This is 2 times 6. That's a prime number. 6 is 2 times 3. These are both prime numbers. So that's the prime factorization for 12. For 20, that would be 2 times 10. And 10 would be 2 times 5. Oops. Now, When I do this, I can use what's called a Venn diagram, and I don't know if you know what those are, but that's when you take two circles and you overlap them like that. And we're going to list 12 here. We're going to have the 20 here, and we're going to list everything that they have in common in these, inside this part right here. Okay? Everything that they have in common is going to go in this intersection between the two circles. So let's look at what they have in common. Both of them have a 2 in common, so you would write it down. And once you write it down, cross it off. I see another 2 that they have in common, so I'm going to write it down and cross it off. Now, once you've done that, you still have other numbers that you have to deal with. For 12, I still have a 3, so you write it down on the outside of the intersection. And 20 has the digit 5. So those are all of the numbers that I need to deal with because I've used everything. That's why I like to cross it out. Now, once you are done and you've got to this point, all you do is multiply all these numbers. And once you multiply all of the numbers together, that will be your least common multiple. So that would be 3 times 2 times 2 times 5. And you should be able to do that. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 times 2 is 12. And 12 times 5 is 60. So the least common multiple between 12 and 20 is 60. Okay, that is all for least common multiple. And when I come back, we're going to talk about adding or making equivalent fractions.